Walking down that motel, 6th Street. I was headed to that raggedy strip club. That strip club in that hole in the wall where it was dark enough so you couldn't see I was young. Right down there by Central Avenue. You know that Motel 6 on Central Avenue,
yep.
If you're from this area. And every day I would walk my life away. And I didn't realize that there was somebody watching me as I was doing this walk. Somebody watching me who knew exactly what that walk was about. See, I didn't know somebody was watching me, but she did. Okay. Oh yes, I was watching. I'm Shannon, guys, better known in the times where we're talking about as peaches and cream. That was my theme song, you see. Let me tell you what I wanna do. Let me show you that I'm feeling you. Yes, that was me. Peaches and cream. But at the time, I didn't know what our connection was or would be, but I was drawn to this girl. I couldn't take my eyes off this girl. She intrigued me. What is she doing? Where is she going? And why I keep looking at her? What does she have that I want? I just didn't know. Until one day, after a long, long night. A long night where I had a grueling, grueling quota. A quota well over $1,000. Can you imagine trying to make over $1,000 on Central Avenue by Motel 6? Hard to come by, my friend. I walked into that hotel room, tired of doing this alone, tired of having the weight, the pressure of the world on my shoulders. I felt like nobody understood what I was going through. I felt like nobody understood what it was like to stand on the corner. I felt like nobody. But I walked in and I saw her and two other girls. And it was like I knew someone had the anthem of what I was going through with each step. And it went a little something like this. The time is now 8:00. Time to get ready. I got a hot date, just can't keep him waiting. The game is sweet, the money is right. Take a look in the mirror. Making sure my issues right. Oh yeah, sure enough, cause tonight is a good night for me to stack more paper. If I work real hard tonight, maybe tomorrow will be better, so I won't be standing on the corner waiting for a
I felt to walk in and see other victims just like me in there with my pimp. I didn't mean to be relieved at your presence, but when I looked at you, I remembered something, that there was something called not being alone. Not having the weight and the pain of someone else's expectations so rigidly on my shoulders as my body was being broken down night after night. There would be someone to take that weight on their shoulders with me. And then suddenly, we became a team, a family of captives under one brutal ruler. We were under this brutal ruler for quite some time, you see. Quite some time. And we grew closer. And we grew closer. Until suddenly we remembered, or we thought to ourselves, maybe me and you and the other girls with us might be more important than that lie that rolled over us. And I didn't realize that it was real and that the friendship was real until that night that he decided that my life was no longer worth living, and he beat me. And he beat me. And he beat me until blood began to ooze from my body, and I was hemorrhaging, and I was dying. And he came to finish the job, and suddenly someone stepped in. That was the night. That was our last night. I couldn't watch him beat her anymore. I couldn't watch him break her spirit anymore. I got courage. Courage I didn't even know I had, but I was willing to fight more for her life than I was my own. So I said, no more. You're not as big as you think you are. You're not as powerful as you think you are. I didn't know that greater was working on the inside of me at that time. My strength was coming from a place that I know of, but didn't really recognize, wasn't in a place to recognize at that time. So I said, no more. I banged on the door. Let her out! Let her out! You can't have her! She's ours! You gotta go. We don't need you anymore. We are strong, stronger than you. And guess what? We got friends right here willing to help us too. If you've never seen a group of girls who were beaten and broken stand together in unity to fight one enemy, you don't know what you're missing. What it felt like to have them stand up to the one who I knew could kill them for my life. But see, what I didn't realize was that someone else was searching for me. I didn't realize that the moment that trafficker that was run out by us, them, these ladies, these oppressed women, and some of the hustlers that we knew that helped them, drove that pimp, that trafficker, right out of the door, but I still laid there, bleeding to death. And it was right at that very moment, you see,
that I decided that I would call on someone that I didn't think would even speak to me. Jesus. And I remember feeling like the name was rising up in me, but it was trying to convince me that I didn't know it, but I kept hearing the whisper of it.
Jesus.
I kept thinking that maybe it's my imagination, maybe it's because I'm dying, maybe I'm having a near-death experience, but that name kept coming and it kept saying.
Jesus.
So I finally stopped just listening to it. And I began to say it out of my mouth, Jesus.
Yeah.
I began to say it again out of my mouth, and I began to say, Jesus, if you see me, if you hear me, heal me. And at that very moment, all of my bleeding stopped. At that very moment, that hemorrhaging I was experiencing internally, because I had just had an abortion that day, so bleeding was physically impossible to stop, stopped. And I realized that Jesus was real. And I was so excited to say, I want to see you, Jesus. But all along, he was saying he wanted me to see me.
Standing here, I feel so free. I now have an identity. You see, the person I was before has died and gone. She lives here no more.
That's our story, everyone. That's our story.
Yes.
Now, I know that we're wrapping up. But there's somebody who's here that is very, 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 very important to me. I mean, when I say important to me, I mean important to me to the bottom of my heart. And I have been waiting 7 years to see her again face to face. 7 years. You won't hear her story, because her story belongs to her. But I met her at age 13, doing what I do now. And today she's 20. And so that explanation should be enough. But I love her. And I look at her like my daughter. And I want to introduce the beautiful, the amazing,